We started 9 or 9.5 years ago. I had read 2 or 3 of Vince's books, and I thought, wow, these are great. I won, you know, somebody must already have these, you know. And I looked into the rights, and they were available, and, you know, we were able to get it, and it's been a very long journey to get here. Whoever we were going to cast as Mitch, to some degree, we had to cast so that you went along the ride with him. So you had to have a guy who was emotionally accessible enough and a good enough actor to transition from that person to the guy who's picking up a gun and deciding right and wrong. And that's when we came upon Dylan. And I felt like he was maturing enough that he could carry the role. And I think in watching the dailies and watching the scenes, Dylan's really an exceptional actor. And so I think you're going to go along the ride of, let's call it the, you know, how, you know, it's not how you become an assassin. It's how do you become the hero? Dylan has done a great job of learning the fights incredibly well and convincingly, and being convincingly tough in them as well, not just knowing the moves, you know. So he's learning kind of tactical fighting. There's no single style. And I think that's true in the books. You always feel like he is improvisational and you're not seeing him each time go, okay, you know, or okay, you know. So I think in this case, what we're doing is there's different pieces in different fights. He resorts to different things, sometimes in desperation, sometimes in calculation. And I think that makes you go, one, he doesn't feel unbeatable. You know, he's not so good at kung fu that you're like, ah, come on, you know, or so good at, you know, he's really good at every form, but there's some improvisation that's going on. And so in those moments, I think of improvisation is where you think the character's in trouble. We were thrilled when he was interested in doing it because it felt like we knew as an actor, he's such a good actor that he would be able to portray the character. But we didn't want anybody to feel, oh, we're doing the cliche version, you know? So our hope was whoever we were going to cast, we were going to try to design it in a way that you didn't feel like, oh, I saw that in a movie before. The mentor character who does da-da-da-da. So Michael always has this really kind of edgy tautness as what I always like about. So you're a little bit like, where is he going, right? And I think that's what you want from Hurley. You want him to put you off center. The construction of Ghost is this idea of a guy who's wildly competent, right, and feeling betrayed. And unfortunately for every one of us, has the skills to do something that could be really dangerous. So he needed to have that sense of like, wow, that is, you uncorked the wrong force. We are definitely delivering the audience a global scale of things. And I think what it also does is when you keep changing locales, you have to recalibrate in a certain level as an audience member. Like, okay, now we're here. Why are we here? It feels like stakes are escalating as you're moving, which is what we're doing. And I think you feel cheated if, as an audience member, I would feel cheated if it didn't feel like it had that kind of global implication of things rippling out in different ways and forms.